back. I'm trying to find my, the goddamn thing that I left, but if it doesn't want to be found, I won't. So we can finish up.
The Ivory Brigade has need of you.
I've already heard, as with any. For this chap, complete your task.
Nice, so I mixed that undone. That's cool. antelope.
To observe the ruin, not help you mount a suicidal rescue mission.
Then you can observe me kicking every fetching cultist's ass standing between me and my little brother. Who are you? Another of these useless Leowin layabouts? No, you're an adventurer. My little brother and I answered a job posting seeking adventurers to help explore a newly discovered route. Free my little brother and the others before something terrible befalls them. There were five, in addition to me, who got duped into this. My brother, Liam, Eolaf, a Nord warrior, Ardia, a high elf. Not much. Zagira, the woman who hired us, was charming. I didn't buy her story. About the time they said, don't kill her, we need her for the ritual, while trying to wrestle me to the ground. Probably saved my life, though. I fought twice as hard, knowing they were... We didn't get far with our expedition before things went sour. But the ruin was in pretty bad shape. You'll need a grapple bow to get anywhere quickly. Fortunately, all right. But remember, you already agreed to help me. It'd be rude to back out now. It's Daedric, in origin, our employee. 100 years old at most. I couldn't tell you who built it or how it came to be demolished, though. I didn't get much time to study it before. Just line up your sights with a suitable anchor point, release the bolt, and get... Be careful. There's a lot more cold.
Elder Scrolls and the infinite amount of cultists that exist.
It wasn't like this before. We should hurry. The bridge is out, but that support looks sturdy enough for the grapple bow. That's Yoloth, one of the other adventurers Zagira duped with this setup. Zagira had us escorting her scholars around the area to place those so-called surveys. I damn well planned to try. It'll be dangerous, though. For Yoloth, most of all. That ritual is already feeding off of him somehow. A sudden shot. That array by Yoloth seems to be the heart of the ritual, but the magic is being drawn to another focal point nearby. Destroying that might lighten the load on Yoloth, and the backlash of ending the ritual by force. We need to stop that ritual, the sooner the better, but Yoloth's chances of surviving go up exponentially if we try picking it apart carefully, instead of smashing the central array right at the start. The grapple bow should help us search around. I don't know it. I'm making an educated guess. Daedrology is my main field of study, though I tend to avoid getting caught up in their worship and rituals. Mostly, I'm fascinated why anyone would join these... I took an interest in the anticipations of the Tribunal and my ancestors' worship of them before the three rose to godhood. Dark elves aren't the only ones who revere Daedra alongside divines, but now's not the time for a philosophical discussion. Ritual's weakened.
Thanks mightily. Trying to pitch me into Orki's gnarled teeth. I'm just hired muscle. I don't meddle with magic. They were talking. Haven't felt this bad since I nearly drowned in the sea of ghosts. But I can...
It worked! Sorry if that... that sounds too much like surprise, but I couldn't be sure if that it was definitely
a so she's your love
not
is the guinea
pig. Typical sacrifice. Offerings to the princes are usually quick and brutal. This was much. The Swiss didn't tell us much of their plans before stabbing us in the back, but I've got a rough. Recognize that journal. It belonged to Ardia. Well, I'll be. Ardia actually made a break for it. She's the last one I'd have expected to escape. Two left feet. Honestly, I'm impressed she made it this far, but my gut tells me she. It's getting to the point that I hardly recognize this place. It's like the sky is on fire and everything. It's possible this is all just a side effect of the ritual, not its intent. Who knows? Maybe their magic isn't just feeding on the souls of those they've captured, but everything here. All the more reason to stop them quickly. Lava? And look, those trees! The shifting is more drastic here. Let's keep looking. The array. Come on, watch your step.
I'm just a little unsteady. Normally, I love new experiences. It's why I got into exploring. Not that one. Oh, I thought I'd never see that again. Thank you. I have a great deal to add to it now. I think it's good to record all you can, good and bad. It forces you to think about what you've seen and done, makes you more mindful of how events shape you.
That's like not a bad clip.
Zagira was yelling at her followers about jeopardizing the foothold when I was trying to escape. I don't quite get what she meant, but I think they're turning this place into their stronghold. And I saw Zagira when they caught me, the real Zagira. Among her followers, she dropped the mask she'd been wearing. She's a Daedra. These cultists are the usual misguided fools dabbling with things they don't really understand. It looks like Ardia will be all right. I can't be certain, but Dijo, Skarlor, and my little brother Liam are still missing. I have a theory about the purpose of these rituals. The changes to the land, the sky, the blood. I think this ruin isn't actually part of Nern. More like a piece of our world bottled up, and the cult is trying to fill the bottle from another source.
He's gone. Soul shriven. I've read accounts of this happening, but... Right. You're right. This isn't the time to lose it. There's still hope for the others. Garlor couldn't have wanted... This focal point is finished, but it wasn't the only one by the look of it. Let's do the same to the rest. Split up! The ritual must have several. You're free! Come on!
Came back for me? Thanks to you, there will be something left. Dark elves have not been kind to my egg kin, and I have not been kind to the heart of the vault, she said.
We managed to save her. I don't know if that'll improve her opinion of me.
We'll...
No, I don't care about that hooded viper. I just want my little brother back.
Put your priorities.
Our way, I'll gladly kick a fetching ass back to oblivion. Come on, Liam needs me.
lights locked us out. We aren't getting that gate. I think that mechanism must be connected to the gate, but that can't be the only...
A little lava is going to stop me. You've got another thing coming.
Going to save Liam and stop Sigur. I don't know. He's my little brother. I have to try. If it comes to it, end the ritual prematurely. I'd rather.
Okay, don't accidentally go to it.
Hey, Beck. I'll get you
Mary,
out of here.
I thought I'd never see you again.
Some mattress are my source of leather. I should be finding mattress.
You can inform your worthless legates that we stopped the cultists. No thanks to you.
Just be grateful your little dispute didn't land you afoul of the law. Cease.
We did it! My little brother is safe and that backstabbing viper Sagira's plans are in shambles.
I suppose you helped the Dark Elf rescue.
We did it! We leave this useless swit to his report and count Azora's lucky stars. My little brother is alive and well, thanks to you. That's more than I could ask. We owe you. If you ever need anything, and I mean anything, you can count on me. I should get word that we're safe to our parents as soon as possible. I hope to see you again soon. And Liam, straight to Leowyn, you hear?
I just want a moment to catch my breath and thank your friend here, Mother. Thought I was finished there. Miri, too. I was...
Thank you.
What's on the docket today? Something you need to discuss? What would you like to talk about? You're a pretty good adventuring partner. Problem, Sarah?
Oh, cool, you can give them. Oh, okay. Company. Guess we can go and try and get the best this guy too.
Has need of you.
Have my word. If the counselor is in Leowin or the surrounding countryside, the Ivory Brigade will find
Biko,
you there.
Over here.
A moment of your time, please.
Thanks for your aid.
A fucking bear on two legs. The fuck? Sorry, you're next to a hip center.
Really don't like your odds.
Wait.
Maybe we can add that to the list of things I can beat you at. What would you like to talk? I love maps and old books. Oh, I can lose myself in a library or booksellers for days on end. I'm also a bit of an enophile. It means I like wine. A lot. Change of plans? find something interesting.
You have caught me in a moment of indecision, stranger. I set out with the idea. I am Zeechus. I deal in rumors. Strange figures in hoods. Travelers who disappear.
I need some help. Thank the eight divines. I could really use some help. The name's Bastion. Watch yourself, friend. I was accosted by a dark elf at this very... The dark elf Tanare Vels. She's a traveler I met along the road. The cave is deep scorn. Untie me, please. The Silvels will pay well if you help me get Quisley out of whatever trouble he's in. And I could use someone to watch my back. Thank you. Look around, would you? I'd like to examine whatever my attacker dropped. Saw something fall out of Tanare's satchel when she ambushed me. Why? This is a contract. Damn it. I guess that explains why Tanare knocked me out and tied me up. I ought to just let the Dark Elf have him, but it would be dishonorable. We better see if we can catch up to her. Probably? Yes, I did. We were just idly talking all the time. House Silvel has interests in a dozen cities. I travel all over Tamriel, looking after this. Miss Vels fostered me from the time I was small, seeing to my education and giving me a place in their home. No, not that I noticed. She said to keep an eye out for smugglers. I should try to hide it better, I suppose. We were raised together, more or less. Except, well, it's the right thing to do. I mean, Miss Vels. This is different for Quisley. He's not one for any sort of rough living. Probably. Yes, I did. We were just idly talking on Mrs. Vell. No, I should... Well, it's the...
I didn't know Mudcrabs on my... Come here, I've been missing on this potential... lever.
There's more to this place than meets the eye.
Oh,
this time I've had to look for Quisley in such a rustic location. His usual style. This is definitely
too. There's a cult of Sithis in these caves. They sacrifice. Thank you. We've been here for days.
You should get out of here too, stranger. These people, the Unmakers, they're crazy. I've met no one by that name, but that doesn't mean he isn't here somewhere. The only non-cultist I've seen in days was a dark elf. They're cultists, I think. They follow someone called the Daughter of Sithis, and they talk about sacrifice.
Before we continue, let's talk a moment. Cultists? That explains some of the decoration in here. So much. What's there to know? They worship a god of death, darkness, and primordial chaos. Allowing Quisley to be dragged off to angry criminals is not much of an improvement. While Quisley might deserve it, I can't let him. It's a long story. Suffice it to say, I owe his family a great debt. That's what the Silvels say when they need me to help him. But he's their son. I'm just someone they raised. I've lost count. I'm the son of Lord Martell Hallex. I suppose the story's not well known outside of court circles. My father was one of High King. He failed, of course. Others in my family were implicated in the plot. The High King's.
Oh, Ashton seems nice.
Lay a finger on me. You have no idea who you're dealing with.
Xanathar, give me patience.
What is the meaning of this intrusion? Who are you people? What are you? Quisley Silvel? He belongs to Laleus now. She is the daughter of Sithis, a nun. No! No! Quisley is Laleus's consort. You'll find
Oh my, I knew it.
I think the way there is back the way you came, or maybe ahead. They caught a dark elf sneaking around. Even now, she faces the death of the Crystal Fae. We follow Sithis, Serpent of Chaos, Unmaker, Bringer of Endings. The daughter of Sithis claims this place has been sacred to the Unmaker for years uncounted. Only when all has been consumed, war tears the Empire apart. Daedric.
I don't believe him. The daughter of Sithis? The Fane of Hardly. The only thing that interests Quisley is himself. Either these Sithis followers hid their true nature to men that he doesn't realize he's in danger. I'm not sure I believe this sniveling cultist, but we shouldn't let anyone get sacrificed. Not even Tenare Vels. Let's split up.
Please, I'll tell you anything you want. I know where a map of this place is. It's not far. Just, you know, don't hit me.
Helpful of you. What else can you tell me?
Help! Break these crystals! Please, they're killing me!
Thank you, stranger. Let's talk somewhere safer.
He said a question, really loved this transition to like a nearby tomb.
Those still feels like I've got 1,000 tiny spiders biting me.
Facial strength.
That was horrible. Oh, and thank you. Ah, the dutiful and not terribly clever mage. I'll bet. Then you understand my predicament. I need Sylvel if I want Law's Tull off my back. But it's not worth getting myself killed. Not much. Law's Tull suspected that Quisley was hiding out in a smuggler's cave on the coast. I thought I'd have to check them all. He must be in deep. If Law's Tull is willing to write off what I owe to get his claws on Quisley. I borrowed gold against imagined winnings like every gambler ever. I found notes left behind by some unfortunate scholar. He'd apparently come here to make... I did. It's all the way down at... Good. I saw a rough map of this place before I got caught. So I think I know where to go. I'll keep out of your way if you run into more cultists. After that ritual, no condition for a fight. The cultists definitely go on and on about cities.
I met you.
Huh.
Something you needed.
End and a vampire in a cage. This isn't terribly helpful. There's got to be a way through. I know what I saw on the map. I would have sworn the map I saw showed a passage. If he's been here long enough, he must have... Perhaps. But I'd rather not fight my way through half the cult.
Your comrade is correct. There's a hidden door. You're not part of this cult, are you? In fact, you appear to be lost. Your dark elf friend watches me with no small amount of suspicion. Perfectly un- I have heard the name. The daughter of Sithis herself has him. Your dark elf- I have heard the name. The daughter of Sithis herself has him. These miserable Sithis- They hid the switch for a secret door under that crate over there. Lelace is a noble from Leowen who made a game of dabbling. Fools and dilettantes bewitched by the daughter's powers. They believe she is the living embodiment of Sithis.
Huh. Surprisingly helpful.
Wait. Would you do me a favor in return? Perhaps before you rush off, you might unlock this cell? I came here hoping the temple held answers about my condition. But the cultists discovered me as a wary noble from Gideon. The daughter of Sithis was intrigued, but when she realized I had not yet mastered my powers, she locked me away. Yes, that would be an elegant solution to my predicament. I'm still capable of gratitude, stranger. I just want to be free of this place. I came here expecting something quite different.
He's new, yet he's in control of his home. Well, she... Oh, best did not like it.
thinking.
Okay. Want to fill me in or you think?
I stumbled headlong into a bad situation once already. I do try to learn from my mistakes. Nothing good. I wouldn't go so far as to say that it comes down to bringing Quisley in or taking his place, but it's close. This may sound ghoulish, but if Quisley is dead, I'd like his signet ring. It's big. Someone's coming!
Oh, there you are! I'm afraid I wasted my time on that cultist. He knew nothing. Glad I caught up to you.
Talk to me.
Oh, you put the fear of the gods into our captive cultist. He was sobbing on the floor when I gave up and left. I did meet a surprisingly... Our weepy friend told me that Quisley's quite taken with this daughter of Sithis. Figures. My guess is he told her his family is wealthy. She seems like the sort who expects the worst. I remain optimistic. I don't always get along with Quisley. Not at the cost of his life. I'll figure out something. I always do.
No, he looks strange.
But just in case, warn Tanari that she'd better not try anything foolish when we get Quisley. You're not even going to apologize, are you?
I'm sorry.
Just keep your distance from Quisley. He's my
Well, bookshelves are so inconsistent. Like, some, like, just now we found a few.
In a fight right now. I'll keep back.
What are you doing here? Go away.
Arise, my brother.
I'll just
kill these trespassers.
I'll get out of the way.
Huh. I don't know if everybody's so hard.
Before he runs off again, you little bastard.
How dare you? Lelise would never have hurt me. She said so.
She murders people. You idiot. You were probably next.
I'm not talking to you, Bastion. Nor to that rude dark elf that just laughed at me. Everything. You and that lumbering oaf my father insists on sending to make my life... Well, that's just your opinion. Everybody here treated me as a guest of honor. And Lelace, the daughter of Sithis, chose me to be her consort. She told me that she'd... Did you ruin this for me? I can't believe they sent Bastion after me again. They treat me as if I were a wayward child. I am perfectly capable of... That is no concern. Wait. Did you say Lar? Claim me I am not some sack of flour to be bargained over. Oh, very well.
Bastion doesn't seem very fond of Quisley. I can't imagine why. Years ago, I lost everything trying to get my brother out of a fishy trading scheme. Lars Tull offered to help me. If Bastion's willing to work with me, and perhaps forget about the knocked out and tied up business.
Once we get Quisley out of here, I'm done. I've paid my debt to his family 3 times.
Yes, King.
All right. I think I know how to sort this out. First, we need to get Quisley out of Blackwood. Tenare doesn't have anything personal against him. Well, I'll threaten to tell his parents about this whole affair unless he cooperates and goes straight back to Daggerfall. Quisley knows that Lord Silvel can cut him off. It's the only threat that actually scares him. He would have to earn a living. I think we can all walk away from this. We ship Quisley home, secretly. Then we make sure that Tenare has something she can take back to Lars Tull. Thank you, friend. I think Lord Silvel would agree that you've earned your payment.
Oh.
What do you think, Tenare? Are you willing to give it a try?
I'll need to bring Lars Tull proof of Quisley's demise.
What kind of proof would you need?
I'm clearly not dead!
If I bring Quisley's signet ring to Lars Tull, he'll believe me.
That's what I was thinking. I'll tell the Silvels that Quisley sold the ring to pay his debt.
I'm right here!
That ring should work. It might even cover most of Quisley's debt.
What? My ring? I'm not giving you a damn thing! Bastion, keep that woman away from me!
Here you go. I'll make sure Quisley understands to stay away from Blackwood.
Thank you. This should clear my account with Lars Tull. And perhaps clear yours with this ingrate and his family too.
We should leave this place. I'll see Quisley on his way when he comes around.
Yay. Cool. Man.
mechanistic harvesting. Change of plans? What would you like to talk about? We've already been through more together than most people I've known. Problem, Sarah. What would you like to... My dad's an antiquarian. He gave me an appreciation of cultural artifacts. Mom showed me how to find them. I prefer to treat such things with the respect they deserve. Hall.
Visits
a remote Wemmer ruin just before his death. No coincidence. And now the guild openly opposes a Daedric prince. Risky, risky. To throw the guild against such power. Foolish. This one remembers when we fought goblins, bandits.
Oh.
I guess
this is a fight now.
One and done, yes? Almost there. Be on your guard. And here we are, Ragnthar.
I'd like to talk about it. I'm an archer by training, so I try to stay at range. Change of plan?
Welcome to Ragnthar. Ragnthar is twisted out of space. In her travels, Aelif has learned little tricks, and this one will just be a moment. The sound of gears. Watch yourself. Tactic. Are you a protective barrier with some not without your assistance? Aelif will subdue the crystals. Aelif will begin her spell. Prepare yourself. Move your paws quickly. Now, destroy the crystals. To examine the body. That did not sound good. It is a trap. Aelif is pleased to have you at her side. They are called Aurorans, a strange type of Daedra, I think. Let Aelif see.
Yeah, as I say.
This is Jafnir's.
His body
here. The dwarf keeping us out, yes. But perhaps also keeping him in. Perhaps with a barrier down. We speak to him directly. You have seen the spirit of Jafnir. Aelif told you she
had. You asked me like for confirmation like 3 times.
Aelif will start the ritual.
Who summons me?
Hush, spirit.
Draconian, my subordinate.
This one knew it would be so. Be gone, spirit. Aleph is done with you.
I have done as you asked. Release me to walk in Sovngarde.
Go. Aleph will call for you again.
So rude.
Soon. Yeah.
Damn.
Sovngarde, indeed. You heard the guildman. Perhaps for you, this one has suspected all along. The lizard. Find Merrick and the council. They are probably still in their mood.
Can I exit? Can't right click. Oh, is there someone waiting for me outside? I can't right click. I think someone's waiting for me outside. Like, I can't right click the Summa Ultimate. Let's see it.
What a sight! Oh, I can't wait to write home about this.
I'm gonna grab the... Yes, Osinia.
Greetings to you.
Oh, those are the messages. Oh, let's keep.
What news do you have? I didn't even want to let myself think it. When she disappeared after your visit to the Aeliot ruin. What? Aelif did what? Stendar's breath, that's disgusting. I'll have to talk to her when she sees all colors will be found and thrown in a cell. Stay in touch, comrade. We will need you when the time comes. Until then.
I need to speak to you immediately. I have an urgent... Aelif needs to speak to you immediately. I don't... She's waiting for you at the Evermore Guild Hall in Benkerai. Not as far as I know. Every member of the guild received...
So we've come full circle. I led the original five companions on a quest to reclaim. Perhaps, but I wonder, will history repeat itself or rewrite itself? In truth, I fear it was a holy city in the first era, founded by Queen Alessia herself. It is in the mountains of Calovia, the land of my youth. But I have little memory of that time. My exposure.
Time has come for us to enter the catacombs of Sancretor. I have been through much, but this body is tougher than the great oaks of Valenwood. I go with neither hope nor fear. It is useless to guess at a few. My Lord Varen will open a gateway to Sancretor. The amulet lies in the room. The time has come. I have been through much, but this body is tougher than the great oaks of Valenwood. I go with neither hope nor fear. It is useless to guess at a future that has yet to be written. You may hope if you wish, my friend. I will not judge. My Lord Varen will open a gateway to Sancretor. The amulet lies in a vault protected by powerful magic, a ward of Stendar, the god of justice and mercy. Also a god of well-earned luck. I thought this could matter. It is written that Alessia received the divine inspiration for her slave rebellion at Sancretor, and so built her holy. We should avoid the Crypt of Heroes. I saw enough angry dead there to fill 9 lifetimes. Kasura and I barely escaped with our lives. The catacombs contain 2 shrines dedicated to the...
Hope we find something in?
Oh, yeah. Nope. Better be in for... Christ.
Return with the Amulet of Kings.
You could have hidden that amulet anywhere in Tamriel, and this was your first choice?
It seemed like a good idea at the time.
Brilliant. Why is it that the people with the most ridiculous ideas are always the ones who are most certain of them?
Shut up, Tharn.
Looking for an amulet, perhaps?
In a Merkel. How did you find this place?
Do you really think I'd allow you to escape the walls of torment if I couldn't track your every move?
Sai, no! Menemarco, stop! You're killing him!
Where is the Amulet of Kings? My master, Moloch Vaal, demands it!
Your master, please. You would use the amulet to betray Moloch Vaal.
Fool! When I ascended, you could have been at my right hand! Darn! Instead, you chose to align yourself with mongrels and imbeciles. Now, you'll die with them.
You won't get away with this. Do you really think you can betray a Daedric prince?
With the Amulet of Kings, all things are possible. Nations will tremble and bow before me. I will be a god!
The Amulet of Kings will never be yours. It is protected by a ward of the Divines!
You mean your ward of Stendar, god of merciful forbearance, patron of gutless, law-abiding dimwits? It won't even slow me down.
Menemarco has...
Oh, shit, I dropped his cool ass move.
We led him right to the amulet. Menemarco may be powerful enough to break through Stendar's ward eventually. If we can get to the shrines quick, we must make our way to the inner courtyard.
Sai, are you well enough to continue?
Have no fear, Snow Lily. I am Redguard. We are like mountain bamboo. Far stronger and more flexible than we might appear. Through that gate lies the Crypt of Heroes. We can enter if you wish.
of Stendar's ward. It will never be yours.
Sigh. You still don't understand, do you? My plan will succeed because of your ward of Stendar. It will prevent Molag Bal from observing or interfering. By the time the ward is down and the amulet is mine, it will already be too late.
You're insane if you think you can betray the god of schemes.
Naive child. You know nothing. Chimmel Adabal, the red diamond at the center of the Amulet of Kings, is the most powerful soul gem ever created.
Oh.
With the amulet in my possession, I will absorb Molag Bal's power, reducing him to an empty husk of ethereal flesh. Then I will trap his essence within the gem.
Oh, I like how he gives me a PowerPoint presentation. Thank you, Merimako. Wow. Very cool.
In time, the name Molag Bal will be forgotten. In time, all of Tamriel will bow down before me. Soon, the god of schemes will have a new name. Manimako.
Friends, I must rest before we continue.
Sigh. Are you all right? That bastard really hurt you, didn't he? I swear to the gods, I'll take his head off.
Yeah. I'll be fine, Snow Lily. I just need a moment to catch my breath.
Take all the time you need. I'll keep watch. If there's anything I can do, just name it.
An enchanting moment. I'll be over here bringing up my lunch.
Ha!
You better keep an eye on me. I'm getting ready. Sai Sahan is nothing if not determined. He once told me that achieving victory is like wrestling an ogre. You don't quit when you're tired. You quit. Me. I'll chase Manimarco to the furthest corners of oblivion if I have to. Vengeance is a powerful motivator. We're two of a kind. Stoic. Isn't that what people call us?
Zed's tears. I have pushed my body much further than this. It is my mind that pains me. That voice. Menemarco's voice. Taunted me. I will make it through this, my friend. I did not endure years of torture in the halls of torment, only to give up now. We must consecrate the two shrines with Stendar's blessing before the vault can be opened. The first shrine rests in the... The shrine is on the far side of the room. Quickly, we must find our way across.
I have a surprise for you, Sai. Do you remember your fallen comrades from the giant? Taken the liberty of raising them, and they're quite anxious.
I have no wish to disfigure the corpses of my old comrades in the Dragon Guard. We must consecrate the shrine.
Beck, I hope you're watching.
Surely the four of you can handle one skeleton. Concerning that the companions we have to save the world. Took that long to kill one skeleton.
You certainly did a thorough job hiding the amulet, Sai. Couldn't you have just stuffed it in a mattress or something?
Second shrine is in the chamber beyond. There is a trick to reaching it. The altar is on the far side, but to reach it, the drawbridge must be lowered.
Smells. This place has all the charm of a rift and brothel.
Huh.
It must feel very much like home to you, Titan.
You mean a crypt filled with the rotting corpses of inbred kings and failed statesmen? Must be what it's like at a Tharn family
I found that it's convenient antechambers for him.
Sword of my father, you will not win, Menomarco.
Soon, you will know the extent of my power and bow before me. Through the power of the Amulet of Kings, I will be transformed. All the nations of Tamriel will bow before me. They will worship me and beg for my mercy. All will know the name of man.
shrines have been consecrated in Stendar's name. Stand in the casting circle and direct the ring of the doors to lift the ward. The door should open. Look, the amulet. I can see it from here.
Oh, we gotta fight Mary Margaret. Come here, bitch.
Brutality and domination without consequence. You will pay for your arrogance. You will writhe in agony for the rest of eternity. Your tortured screams will echo throughout oblivion to serve as a warning to others.
Damn.
Marco did was designed to pit us against each other. We can't let that happen. Look what we can accomplish when we work together.
How uncharacteristically optimistic of you, Titanborn. I may have that embroidered on too.
The Divines gave you a nose for a reason, Tharn. So you can keep your mouth shut and still keep breathing.
Well played, Titanborn. Well played.
Oh.
Marco will pay dearly for the rest of eternity. One cannot out-scheme the god of schemes without paying a heavy price. I cannot imagine.
Oh, so more about MVP.
Sai Sahan must rest, as must we all. We can sleep a little easier knowing the King of Worms has been defeated, but we cannot rest too long. I've not forgotten, Vestu. It's another piece of the puzzle. We shall address it in due
time. Not the final boss, I guess.
Let us rest and recover. As always, I will contact you soon. Walk in the light, Vestu.
Whoopie doo.
give them some privacy.
Oh, I was anyway.
Believe it. Where's the trust? Pop on out to the rubbish tip, Cadwell. There's a good lad. My mind? Oh, I have no mind. I'm the village bloody idiot.
Welcome back, Vestige. News of Manimarco's demise spreads far and wide. As ever, straight to the point. You've done the impossible. Welcome back, Vestige. As ever, straight to the point. You've done the impossible. The King of Worms has been consumed by the wrath of Lord.
Yeah, I found my goddamn soul.
That is the grim truth of the matter. But the Amulet of Kings is in our possession, and there is still much to do. In my sleep, I hear his tormented screams, and Molag Bal forces visions of his eternal torture into my mind. I can show you exactly what I see, if you behold the fate of the King of Worms.
Please! It was a misunderstanding, great one. Let me serve you. Let me prove my loyalty. No more, I beg of you.
Manimarco's torment will be endless. The god of schemes will use him to set an example. All who follow him will know you cannot hope to betray the greatest of betrayers. I cannot help but pity him, despite all he has done. But this is not why you were called here, Vestige.
Sword Saints Divod tells us that destiny is a chain, forged one link at a time. Our chain is nearly complete. There is but one link remaining. It is you, my friend.
Oh.
You are the link. I will not bore you with effusive praise, but state it plainly, you are a great warrior and a trusted friend. We would like to extend you an offer. When Emperor Varen first brought the five companions together, he did so in the hope of creating a Tamriel where all men could live freely and safely beneath one banner. The five companions failed, betrayed from within by one of our own, the Worm King Manimarco. All that came after was the result of one man's treachery. Now four of the five are reunited to right that great wrong, but destiny requires...
And I didn't have to right the wrong. Fuck you.
We want you to join us as our fifth member.
Whoa!
You were the champion. Don't look so grave. This is largely symbolic. But please, humor an old soldier.
Call me that anymore, Sizerhan. We are equals now.
All those years ago, when we fought beneath our Lord's banner to free the Empire from the Long House Emperors, we did so with a dream of freedom and peace in mind. Not just for the Empire, but for all of Tamriel. Together, we forged a fellowship stronger than any blade, only to see it shattered upon the rocks of deceit by one of our own. That fellowship is no more. Yet we four have assembled here, united by a single purpose. It is not vengeance that drives us, but truth and loyalty and justice. I, Sai Sahan, steward of the Abbey of Blades, call for the five companions to be reforged this day by the light. Might of Stendar and the Heart of Lorkhan. May our blade of fellowship be forged anew. And may the vestige, our mutual friend and ally, become its tip. That we may thrust it straight into the heart of a Daedric prince.
Sai Sahan is right. You are the member that we should have had all those years ago.
It is as the scrolls foretold. The soulless one will become the brightest of five stars, and they shall guide us to the coming dawn.
Go, please, you melodramatic sots. Fine, fine. If seeing one of your foolish prophecies come true will help to ensure the safety of the Empire, I'll bail.
Stand united once more. The five companions are reforged, and together we will strike down the God of Schemes.
Come here, my friend. I've got a few things I want to say before you go. It's been a long road, hasn't it? My father used to say that if you avoid all of life's abrasions, you'll never be polished enough to shine.
Well.
It must be pretty damn shiny by now.
That's a pretty good quote.
I've been thinking about our adventures and the hardships we've faced together. We're in the last leg of this journey, aren't we? I don't regret any of it, but it occurs to me that we haven't had much of a chance to talk as friends. Where do you see yourself going after all of this is over? I mean, assuming we survive, get your soul back, and stop Molag Bal. Traveling is a humbling experience. You see firsthand what a small place you occupy in the world. Funny thing is, the farther you go, the harder it is to return. But when you do, if you do, you get to see the place you came from with new eyes.
Wow, what? Liz is dropping truth bombs.
I don't know. Maybe I'll go back to Skyrim and settle down. Squeeze out a few whelps. Maybe raise sheep or grow cabbages. What? No. Can you imagine it? Lyra's Titanborn, shepherd, farmer.
Sisa Hunter's crying to make
I need to be out in the wind and wild. And if I ever find my life mate, he'll feel the same way. My turn. What's your one regret about all we've been through?
Missed opportunities to seize power.
You never get used to it. My father, he'll die over and over. Grief doesn't go away. You just learn to live with it. But I can live my life with his daring and spirit and joy. That way he'll never die. Not really. Oh, lots of things. Friends lost. Missed opportunities. Failed endeavors. Maybe the best we can hope for is to end up with the right regrets. I do regret not taking the time to get to know the people I fought with. I hope to change that. One last thing. You like mead? It's been a long... I've been thinking about our... Where do you see yourself going after all of this? I guess you're right. Ah, well. I won't take up too much of your time. You've got destiny and all that written on some moldy old scroll. It's been a long road. I've been thinking about... Where do you see yourself? Bloody business, War. There was a time that I loved my axe for its sharpness and my armor for its sheen, but no more. Today I love what they defend. Don't lose sight of what's behind you and the hatred of what's before you. Can you imagine it? You're a hard heart, eh? No regrets, no tears, no doubts. Don't look back unless you're planning to head in that direction. I guess that's exactly the kind of person we need right now. Lots of things. Where do you see your bloody business? Me? What? That's the real test of character. Anyone can face adversity, but give them power. And you'll see their true colors. Power over others is the way of cowards. Seize the power to choose your own path, to control your own life. That takes real courage.
Deep. True. But I still have my power.
I've been thinking, where do you see yourself going after all of this? Traveling is me? What? No. Can you imagine? You're a hard. Where do you see yourself going after traveling is me? What? You never get used to it. Lots of things. One last thing. You like mead. I knew I liked you. So, let's toast. To Molag Bal, that ugly skeever. May his privates be infected with brown rot fever. May our course be true and our hearts be brave as we march into Cold Harbor to spit.
Okay, a rhyme. Lyrical lyrics.
Let's not forget the struggles that got us to this point. We're almost home. We just have a bit further to fight.
Are you all insane? You do realize what we need to do, right? We have to fight a Daedric prince. Amulet or no, this is going to mean more death. Vestige, come here. I'll tell you what they're afraid to mention. Getting all chummy with Titanborn? I enjoy the company of clever, well-informed people. You really should try it sometime. So, you felled? The farmer doesn't thank the cow when it voids itself on the field, but it still makes the crops grow taller. I suppose it is, but that wasn't the reason for this heartwarming reunion. Varen and I have spoken at length since you recovered the amulet. First, the plain meld must be stopped. Even now, forces gather and plan an assault on Oblivion itself. You must join them. Then, and only then, can you take the fight to Molag Bal himself, to restore protection to Nern and reclaim your soul. I know more about the Daedra than any man or mer alive. For good or ill, my family has always kept ties with the forces of Oblivion, and this much I know. One cannot kill a Daedric prince. But we have the Amulet of Kings. With the amulet in our possession, we may be able to wound him severely, and in the process force him to relinquish every last soul he has stolen, including your own. This is where your condition works to your benefit. The ritual we performed with the Amulet of Kings caused the soul burst and damaged the veil between worlds. If the damage is to be repaired, I must attempt the ritual again, this time with you. Only if we use it here on Nern. But if we were to travel to Cold Harbor, we might be able to harness its power, imbue you with divine agency enough to challenge the Daedric Prince. But there is a price. Calling upon the power of the
amulet in this manner will consume someone's soul, utterly. One cannot channel the power of the gods without paying such a price. Unfortunately, you don't have a soul to consume, and I am needed to perform the ritual. More specifically, one of our three companions. I suspect that's why they're so nauseatingly over. Of course it is. The fact of the matter stands, however. One of the five will need to give their life to fuel this attack when the time comes.
So you said before the vestige arrived, and I've already thought it over. I'll do it.
Oh, that's why lyrics are so sentimental.
You should not need to give your life this way. This is my duty. Penance for my numerous failures. This is my chance to make things right.
The scroll said nothing of this moment, and so I'm not bound to their dictates. Vestige, I ask that you let me do this one thing. All that has happened was because of my hubris. I shall be the one.
Sire, you've done enough. This was Manimarco's doing, not yours.
As the one who will fight the Daedric Prince, the Vestige should decide.
I don't see you leaping to volunteer, Tharn. Saving your own backside again.
Hard as it may be, Lyris, don't be an idiot. I'm the only one who knows the ritual, and we don't have time to teach anyone else.
That's enough. It won't be decided here and now. Vestige, come here. I have some final words for you. It appears we have come full circle, Vestige. That millions of others may live, yes. Do not be troubled. Any one of us would gladly make such a sacrifice. As Tharn has said, there are already plans in motion to infiltrate Cold Harbor. You must be part of them. The chains that anchor us to oblivion draw us ever closer. They must be severed once and for all. When the plane meld has been thwarted and the dust has settled, the five companions will gather one last time to face our destiny. The god of schemes must be stopped, Vestige. That is the only thing that matters now.
Damn. Oh my god, I was gonna say, like, personally I think, like, Varen should be the one. When I realize, actually, maybe we don't even get the choice, because I don't size a hand and Lyris still show up afterwards. I'm gonna keep this.
With me a moment, if you would. Greetings, Adept. Good to see you in person. I am Von Ascalarion, head of the Mages Guild you so ably serve. I have need of your assistance.
Everyone really just ambushes me outside my room, huh?
Yes. It's high time Tamriel was free of Molongbal's grip. The Anchors, the Daedra, the Undead, they devastate our fragile mortal plane. I have a plan. And I need your help. I think you're the only one who can help me see this done. I want you to meet with Copper Daria, leader of the Ring of Daggers. She'll be at the Mages Guild in Daggerfall City.
Thank you.
time you got here. Name's Daria, but my friends call me Copper. I head up the Ring of Daggers. I'll eat sand before I give orders to the King's right hand. You want to help Vanus with his crazy plan? Be my... Really? Zet's tears, you're as crazy as he is. So, what's the bet?
100 gold says there's an attempt on our lives within the week.
That's a sucker bet. The hidden
Finally,
have hit us at
I was
least
beginning
once
to think you'd
for the
never
past 3 months.
Show up here.
All right. 300 says that when the Dominion spies contact us, it'll be Cariel, not Razumdar.
Cariel? That wench knows better than to show her face around me. Mark my words, I'm going to have to hunt her down to slit her
And
throat.
After you do, that 300 gold will buy you enough ale to celebrate for a year.
I'll take that bet.
And share the ale if you win. Let's go. We have a lot of work to do.
Apologies for my lateness. Finally, I was glad to see that my calculations and speculations proved correct. I recently received a message that was apparently meant for you. Well, I was about to portal to Alinor for a proper meal, but since down to the last syllable, it means you need to find the Oracle and make sure she's all right. I enchanted a small boat to take you to an isolated part of Glenumbra, near her last known. As it so happens, the Great Mage, uneasy. Surely you could give you the... What? Do you think I have a boat in my pocket? I did...
Oh, wait, this is the enchanted boat.
Thank you for coming so quickly, champion. I've been consulting with Countess Hakruba of the Fighters Guild. Both of our guilds believe the time has come to take the fight to Cold Harbor. Trust, as always. The Alliance leaders will never agree to join forces. And if our guilds only work with one alliance, the other two will see it as a betrayal. For both guilds, our neutrality is our strength. The war in Cyrodiil has been long and bloody, and all three alliances are spread thin. You're in a unique position. You can speak with authority, but you're not an alliance leader. You're respected. You have a reputation. They may let you get a word in before they leap at each other's throats. In short, you're the perfect diplomat. I found the perfect meeting place. A neutral location far from disputed territories, an island called Sturk. I can get you an audience with each leader and provide magical transportation. You just need to convince them to travel to Sturk. That's all I ask. I'll open the portal. I think it's best that I travel with you and make introductions as a neutral party. That might make things easier.
Sure.
Watch yourselves, outsiders. Give us a good reason and the armagers will cut you down where you stand.
We'll burn you.
And shatter you.
Any questions? I didn't think so.
Silence, Thrush. Master Galarian, please continue.
So saying mages get so dangerous, they get TP anyway.
I have heard tales of this one.
I saved you, bro. Say the Mage's Guild must be so like dangerous, they can just TP everyone. What the hell? They just TP right in the middle of this.
I will stay your execution.
What the fuck you, I'll always kill you.
Choose your words carefully. I'm not a patient king. I will stay your execution. Yes, well, I am both suspicious and curious. If you are an assassin, though, get on with it. To fear death is to fear life. I am Nord. When my time comes, I will embrace it. Sovngarde will be glorious. No meetings, no schemes. But you're not here to talk philosophy. What do you want? Three alliances? Has magical travel rattled your brain? Speak plainly. What do you ask of me? Where the All Flags Army was born. If the other leaders agree, I will attend. If nothing else, it should make a good story. Now leave me before my dinner gets cold.
Shall we move on? Eldenroot. We should have a somewhat warmer reception there, as I have known Queen Irene for quite some time. It is my great honor to present to you.
Vanus, you're so formal. I remember the patience and kindness you showed an awkward, freckled waif all those years ago on Fair Somerset. You captured this child's heart then, and it remains with you to this day.
You warm an old man's heart, my queen. I remember well those halcyon days.
As do I, my old friend. Sorry about all these guards. I'm told they're necessary. These are dark days.
A wise precaution, my queen. My counsel would be no different. If you'll permit it, my companion would like to speak with you.
Sounds so young.
Yes. Let me meet this hero I've heard so much about. It's not often the heroic deeds of one who, by all rights, should be considered a mortal enemy reach my ears. Come, let's talk.
The waif.
Vanus is a dear man. In many ways, he is family to me. Since he has given you his trust, I'm willing to set aside our differences. But under different circumstances, you and I would be sworn enemies. Vanus is a dear man. In many ways, he is family to
me. Oh, the texture.
Since he has given you his trust. Well spoken and point taken. To be perfectly honest, I couldn't pass up the opportunity to meet you. Your exploits are legendary.
Yeah?
A true champion is like a stone cast upon the waters of history. The ripples it creates travel far and wide. Loyalty is a noble thing, but you must also remain strong and self-assured. A true champion is also history's pawn, and history is a cruel and unfeeling master. But enough philosophy.
Everybody speaking is philosophy.
And you need all three of the Alliance leaders to attend this meeting. A bold suggestion. I like it. Very well. I make no promises.
Well, they are pretty easy to convince,
themselves, but I will attend. That much I promise.
I didn't think it possible. Well done! We must return and begin the preparations. We have much to do.
Wait, let me discover the... Oh, what? I can't move. No! I'll discover the wish, right? Fuck's sake. Because I didn't convince my own alliance leader.
Some people don't like the bustle of cities, but I come from a big family, so it reminds me of home. The Fighters Guild. The Glenumber chapter reports.
Oh, Glenumber.
All three leaders have agreed to join us on Sturk. Now comes the tricky part. Individually, the leaders are rational, even reasonable. But get them together and, well, you'll see soon enough. Everything's been prepared. Are you ready to travel to the summit? Then, with your permission, I'll open the portal to Sturk. May Auriel's hand guide us all.
The word has been given.
A moment, please. I'll wait for you on the other side.
Our representative, Captain Alfari, is in charge of security on Sturk. He assures us that all is well there, but keep your wits about you. Good luck.
What extra quest did I do? But anyways, wow, there's some crazy quest. Oh, that was fun. Oh, oh man, I don't know how long this would take. But I think I will. I think I will call it there for now, guys. Thank you guys for watching, and hope you guys enjoyed, and I'll see you guys next time. Take care, buddy.